Imagine a luxury SUV that handles like a sports car. Well, that's what Genesis said when they introduced the GV70, and it's been a hit. But now they've done this. This is the electrified GV70, and it might just be the anti-EV EV. What's it like? Let's go for a drive.
I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. The GV70 in gasoline form, I really enjoyed. And I think by the views of those episodes on this channel, that proves my point. But turning this into an all electric is a completely different consideration. You can end up with something that's very compromised, or you can end up with this. And before we get into what it's like to drive, let's have a look at this electrified GV70 in a little more depth.
This is the GV70 that has been transformed into an EV, so a lot of the mechanicals are the same. However, aero is very different. At the front, you've got that different grille, and underneath, there is a flush underbody. There are two 160 kilowatt motors, one at each axle, but what that means to you and me is day-to-day driving, 429 horsepower combined, and there is a boost mode for 10 seconds, where it makes up to 483 horsepower. This makes 516 pounds of torque. Incredible. The battery is 77.4 kilowatt hours. The max charge rate is 350 kilowatts. There is, of course, V2L, or vehicle to load, so you can run electrical devices on your electrified GV70. Suspension is just like the internal combustion engine GV70. McPherson struts at the front, multi-link at the rear, adaptive dampers. Brakes are the same as well. Four piston front calipers, 360 millimeter rotors, single piston at the rear, 345 millimeter rotors. Wheels and tires are exclusively 20 inches, just like the gas model. It'll tow up to 3,500 pounds. Curb weight of this thing, though, is 5,000 pounds, but given its power, it does give this electrified GV70 a slight advantage in terms of power to weight over the gasoline model.
Inside this electrified GV70, it is fundamentally the same as the gasoline model. There is not much difference. There is one key difference, and that may be my only complaint about this particular GV70. Nearly all of the controls in here are identical to the gasoline models. The only real difference is with these shift paddles, and they're no longer shift paddles. They actually control the iPedal, which is regenerative braking. But I do think that this GV70 is a little bit more enjoyable when you're not using regenerative braking. The only fundamental difference inside this cabin is where this seat is positioned. And that's because they had to put the battery somewhere, and it's in the floor. So what that means is this seat is raised up. I don't know by how much, but I'm seated a little higher than I would be in a gasoline GV70. And here's the thing, regular viewers of the show know I love to sit as low as possible in the chassis. So it does feel like I'm sitting on top of this electrified GV70. It's maybe a moderate complaint, not a serious complaint, not a minor one. I just like this seat to get a little bit lower. I suspect what they've done is they've used exactly the same seat. Instead of changing the brackets and making this sit a little bit lower in the chassis, they've just used the same seat and put it in this electrified GV70. There's great space in the front row, decent space in the second row. I can comfortably fit behind myself in the seating position. No trouble there. Those rear seats do articulate a little bit, so your second row passengers can get comfortable. And there's a decent amount of space under the hatch. Really can't complain. And in terms of ergonomics overall, we've dealt with this before. We know what modern Genesis ergonomics are like. I really don't have too many complaints. What is cool is that you do have two ways to control the infotainment system. One, or I suppose three, if you want to use some voice commands, but you do have the controller here. This is actually a touch screen as well, which is kind of difficult to reach. And then there are some voice commands. I just generally run it on Apple CarPlay. The only other thing I have to mention about the driving experience from this seating position is that it is incredibly quiet in here by nature of this being an electric. And secondly, they do have some augmented sounds here. So there is one sound, I can't remember what it's called, but I'm driving with that mode on, and it kind of does give this electrified GV70 a bit more of a mechanical feel, and it changes pitch and tone by the speed at which you're driving, as well as how much you're using the accelerator. I really like the way they've composed that sound. It makes for a much more enjoyable driving experience. Oh yeah, this is quick with that boost, and the electric motor is making all of the power and torque. This thing is ridiculously quick in almost all circumstances. Kind of runs out of steam at highway speeds, or maybe extra legal highway speeds, but 0 to 60 is a tick over 4 seconds. That makes this significantly quicker than the 3.5T GV70. And on top of it being quick in a straight line, you can really get on that throttle exiting corners. The way that they've resolved the electric motors putting down power is fantastic. This is very much a driver's EV, and this isn't even a six-figure EV. It's very, very well done. Traction is just impeccable. I've never been able to overtax the drivetrain in this electrified GV70. The electric motors just do a fantastic job. I've never seen the traction control or stability control rear its ugly head. It just works very, very well. Dynamically, that's where this electrified GV70 shines. They've added several hundred pounds to this, I think more than they actually disclose, but not much has changed in terms of its dynamic abilities. It's very impressive. It still steers exceptionally well. I really like the steering system. It is electrically assisted, of course, so there's not a lot of feel or feedback, but it is very impressive in terms of turn and response. You can hold the line through any corner just perfectly. You know what this electrified GV70 is doing all the time with your steering inputs. Similarly, braking is excellent as well. Still the same massive brakes that you find in the 3.5T GV70, and they work wonderfully even though there is regen braking going on here. When you're on that brake pedal, it's still very positive. You feel like you can control this. Not quite a millimeter level precision, but still decent modulation and a decent amount of feel as well. And it's kind of difficult to do, especially when you're dealing with something that is electric and has regenerative braking going on. They've done a fantastic job with this braking system in this electric GV70. Handling is really where this GV70 shines. It corners fairly flat, and this is an SUV. This isn't the G70 sedan. This is an SUV, and it still corners really flat. The suspension is a wonderful balance of ride and handling. It is on the firm side. It's a little bit more athletic than you'd find in a more luxury-oriented SUV, but I love the way this suspension is tuned. It's perfect for me. Excellent body and wheel control, and that's even despite the several hundred pounds of added weight to the GV70. They've done an excellent job resolving this suspension. Great body and wheel control. Even when we're driving on some rougher surfaces, this is just fantastic. Very rarely do you feel the additional mass of this electrified GV70. It's only in larger road imperfections, and if you're paying attention day to day, this is just a brilliantly resolved suspension. I can't say enough good things about the way this GV70 electric handles. In terms of its dynamic package, this electrified version of the GV70 is true to form. And if you look at a GV70 3.5T and this side by side, there's not much aesthetic difference. There's not much that distinguishes this electrified version from the gasoline version, just that front grille. Otherwise, no one would really know you're driving an EV. And from the driver's seat, there's not much to tell other than this taller seating position and maybe occasionally feeling that additional mass. But in terms of its overall dynamic package, I love the way this GV70 handles, and the way that they've resolved this complete package, making it an EV, is very, very impressive. Because it's so enjoyable to drive as a complete package, this electrified GV70 is quickly becoming one of my favorite all-around EVs. The best part for me is that when you're driving around in one of these, it doesn't scream, "Hey, look at me, I'm driving in an electric."
How do you spec yours? Well, for me, this is gonna be fairly easy. What you are looking at is the top spec. This is Mauna red and a black interior. Base price in the United States is $65,850. As tested, this is $72,650, and that is a $7,000 premium of the 3.5T Sport Prestige internal combustion engine model. In Canada, it only comes this way. This is $84,000 as tested. That's a $6,500 premium of the top 3.5T. And as far as I'm concerned, just get your electrified GV70 this way. My verdict, well, I think it's clear that I genuinely enjoy driving this electrified GV70. It does exactly what it's supposed to do. And off the top, I said it might just be the anti-EV EV. And here's the reason why. A lot of EVs are styled so that you know it's electrified. In this case, this looks exactly like the regular GV70, save for that front grille. And what that means is this is not a rolling virtue signal like a lot of EVs. And for that reason, I really dig this. But on top of that, the driving dynamics of this electrified GV70 are top notch. The fact that it's electric is just icing on the cake. If you're looking for an EV that doesn't have to make a statement, this is the one you need to look at.
Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 electrified GV70. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even electric GV70s.